Jed here to show you how to use one-touch activation to provision your phone. This is the default method for setting up phones as it provides the most seamless experience. Provisioning is connecting your phone with your network so that you can make and receive calls. This feature allows you to simultaneously connect a phone to GoTo Connect and assign it to a user right out of the box. I'll also talk about what to do if you receive an error message in the process. One-touch activation is only supported on Cisco MPP, Polycom, and Yeaink phones. Check our online resources to verify that GoTo supports your phone. When it comes to one-touch activation, you have two main options. The admin activated option is recommended for companies that have less than 20 users. The devices are activated before they arrive, so you can deliver them to the assigned user or location. The user activated option is recommended when you have more than 20 users. With this option, you wait until the devices arrive, pass them out to each user, and instruct them how to activate their device. I will demonstrate both methods in this video. Be sure to use the chapter markers to find the method that applies to you. Despite which method you plan on using, after placing your equipment order, all of the MAC addresses will be loaded into the device section of your account. These addresses are unique identifiers that allow the device to communicate with the network. It may take several days for these to be loaded to GoTo Admin. In the meantime, ensure all your users are added to your account and assigned a license. Let's start by talking about the admin activated method. Start by signing into the admin portal that can be accessed at this site. I've signed in as a super admin, Lance Bingham. Take note that you may see different icons here depending on your GoTo plan. Click the devices icon. This displays all the devices currently on your account. Take note of the assigned to column and look for those which say activate. Click on that word for the desired device. Now decide if this will be assigned to a user or as a standalone device for something like a hallway phone. If choosing a user device, click the drop-down menu and select the desired user. Once completed, click Activate. Pass them out to the assigned user or location when the phones arrive. Once the phones are plugged in, they will connect to our servers and reflect the correct configuration. Repeat this process for each of the new phones. If you have questions about how to plug in your phone correctly, please see the video playlist link in the video description for help with that. Now let's talk about the user activated method. Before the phone arrives, prepare your list of dialable usernames. If you are wondering how to obtain that information, there is a link in the video description demonstrating how to find that for a single user or how to download a report like you see here. I'm using a Yeaink phone for this step, but the process I'll demonstrate should be the same for Yeaink, Polycom, and Cisco MPP phones. When the phone arrives, you or an IT administrator can perform the required steps on the devices before distributing them, or you can hand out the phones to each user and have them complete the steps. First, if you have not done so already, plug in your phone. Each phone model and manufacturer is different, but locate and tap the Activate soft key.
Please enter your username.
Now enter the numerical dialable username provided by your admin.
Thank you.
Once the device has identified the user information, you'll hear thank you, and the device will automatically update its configuration and reboot, possibly more than once. Activation can take some time depending on your device and network speed. Don't be alarmed if your device's screen is blank during this time. When activation is finished, your extension will display on the phone. Let's talk about what to do if you receive an error message. You may see the account number you have entered is invalid. This happens when you've entered a dialable username incorrectly or the username does not exist. This can be fixed by checking your data and trying the process again. Another is, that option is invalid, please try again. This happens when the user has not been assigned to the device. To fix this, assign the user to the device in the administration portal and try the process again. Finally, there is a code that reads error. This is an unknown error, so don't hesitate to contact customer support if you encounter this. That's all there is to using one-touch activation to provision your phone.